members. Now, election of chairman of the panel on education for the 2023 session. The secretary has notified members that only one valid nomination was received. The member nominated was Dr. Priscilla Leung, nominated by Mr. Stanley Ng and seconded by Mr. Benson Look. Since Ms. Leung is not the chairman or deputy chairman of other panels or any relevant government advisory bodies, here I announce that Dr. Leung will be the chairman of the panel on education this session. Thank you. Now, election of Deputy Chairman of the Panel on Education for the 2023 session. The Secretary has notified members that we have only received one valid nomination by close of application. The member nominated is Mr. Tang Fei, nominated by Professor Lau Chi Peng, seconded by Mr. Chu Kwok Kung. Since Mr. Tang is not the chairman or deputy chairman of other panels or other relevant government advisory bodies, according to the rules of procedures and the House rules, I announce Mr. Tang the deputy chairman of the panel on education this session. Congratulations. Now, let's discuss items for discussion at the next meeting. The schedule of meetings is tabled. We will have our meetings at 10:45 a.m. on the first Friday every month. Please note that the first Friday of April is a public holiday. So the April meeting will be pushed ahead to the 31st of March. Please make a note of that. Next, items for discussion at the next meeting. And what other items for discussion related to education? For the February meeting, the administration proposed the following items for discussion. First, review of sub-degree education and diploma yijing, and a briefing on strengthening STEAM education in primary and secondary school. They wish to brief us on the latest support measures on STEAM education. So for our February meeting, do you have any views regarding these two discussion items? I can see that five members have indicated the wish to speak. 1 minute per member, please. Dr. Teck Chi Yun, Mr. Kenneth Leung, Ms. Lillian Kwok, Mr. Stanley Ng, and Mr. Tang Fei. First, Dr. Teck Chi Yun. Thank you, Chen. If my memory serves, Chair, you have mentioned that you wish to discuss the issue on the low birth rate and low population mobility and their effects on education so that government can be prepared for it. In September, in the start of a school term, there may be many variables and also special arrangements for special education. Two items, please. I would like to report to members that yesterday I had a meeting with the Secretary for Education. And I have raised my concern regarding the effect of low birth rate may have on our education system in Hong Kong. So for sure, this will be an item for discussion in the future. Perhaps they will not be ready in February. But since this issue has far-reaching effect from primary school to university, so this is a highlight item for discussion in our session this year. Next, Mr. Kenneth Leung. Regarding the agenda for our February meeting on STEAM education, I can see that it is mainly about primary and secondary schools. But I understand that many kindergartens have incorporated STEAM education, so perhaps this can be part of our discussion. Second, in our agenda this year, perhaps we can talk about student debt. Because on another occasion, many young people have told us about the regarding the possibility of review of student debt. Over the past decades, there is a review on the use of IT on education every 4 to 5 years. The last review was done in 2015, so perhaps we can continue with this review. Thank you. Next, Ms. Lilian Kwok. Thank you, Chair. Regarding strengthening the support for IT and STEM or STEAM education, before our discussion, is it possible for us to have an update on the implementation of BYOB program? Second, STEAM or STEM or coding education has been developed for over a decade. So what has the EDB done to promote these education? What is the progress? Can we be informed of the progress before the meeting to facilitate discussion? Third, strengthening support of IT. Now, these positions are time limited. Is it possible to include them in the permanent establishment? Next, Mr. Stanley Ng. Thank you. Regarding the February agenda items, I agree with these items, but I think that we need to follow up on the vocational and professional education and training. In Hong Kong, we don't have enough technical or professional manpower. How are we going to enhance these trainings and education on a policy level? Also, how are we going to head towards prosperity? Talents are a very important part of that. With the development of the GBA and the integration into the national development, I think we need to have a more macro view. We have to consider the nurturing of talent under this framework. Next, Mr. Tang Fei. 2 points. First, I agree that time is running out in preparation for the February meeting, but the budget will be announced soon, and resources is something that we need to know more about. How is the EDB going to plan for our future with the decrease in population? If we just ask schools to merge, that is not a long-term solution. There has been voices calling for small class teaching in secondary school. But to my understanding, the Secretary for Education suggested that small class teaching is not appropriate for secondary school. Today, I saw on the news that there is a negative growth in mainland population as well, a drop of 680,000. But I think that this is quite urgent. At least we should discuss this by March. Next, Mrs. Regina Ip, please. Chair, I have no objection to the February agenda. But in the long run, I hope that we can discuss more about the mental health of students. Can the EDB provide some statistics? Regarding the mental health of young people or suicide rates, especially for the past 3 years during the pandemic. Two students had made a suicide pact. So what troubled them to this extent? What can we do to help our young people? I hope that the EDB will be able to provide some statistics so that we can analyze and see how we can help them. Got it. Next, Dr. Chow Man Kong. Thank you. I have two suggested items for discussion. First, regarding tertiary education and follow-up action in national education in secondary schools. Some of the schools' national education has a quality concern. The curriculum does not seem to be appropriate. Next, on students with special education needs, the number of these students is on the rise. There is more support for kindergarten students, but as they grow up and enter secondary school, the support is near non-existent. So we need to discuss this further to improve it. Thank you. Next, Mr. Chu Kwok Kum. Thank you, Chair. I agree that it is important for us to discuss ways to tackle the dropping birth rate. For cross-border students, they will be back to our schools first. Very soon, there will be about 20,000 students. But there may be many problems that arose during the pandemic, such as their mental health issues. So I think we need to keep a close eye on that. And we should discuss this latest by March. Next, Mr. Benson Look. Thank you. 2 points. First, there are many trade or business representatives have expressed concern on the decreased number of young professionals. I believe that these professionals, of course, are trained in tertiary institutions. There are fewer and fewer young architects or engineers. Other than nurturing new blood, how can we retain these talents? We need to look into that. For the BPA, perhaps we propose subsidizing their tuition. Next, for National Education Resource Center, we had a tour there. I understand that they have limited budget. For national education, how are we going to better address the problem of resource allocation?
Next, Mr. Lamson Singh. Thank you, Chair. I hope during the year the Education Bureau can report to us the development of the qualifications framework. We have a fund to support the work of the QF. And a few years ago, the Bureau, together with the Education Bureau of Guangdong, signed an agreement on whether there could be cross-reference of the qualification frameworks of the two places that would be most important for a flow of talents between cities in GBA? Mr. Dennis Lam. Thank you. In the long run, we must have proper planning and development of education so that we can nurture enough talents to serve the needs of local industries. So the curriculum itself is very important, and that should be supported by our examination system. The DSE has been introduced for more than 10 years, and it is high time we reviewed the education system so that we have more supply of local talents. Thank you. Ms. Lillian Kwok speaking for the second time, or rather I should give the floor to Professor William Wong first. Thank you, Chair. I've got three suggestions. One is about teachers. I'd like to know teacher training under STEAM education. Secondly, science, popularization of science and education is important. I'd like to know the corresponding arrangement. And for popularization of science, now for air navigation, for instance, we should see how this can be promoted together with the popularization of science subjects. Ms. Lillian Kwok, thank you. Members have named a number of topics for the whole year. I think we should have something on vocational training. We should have programs in Hong Kong to allow our local talents to sit for professional qualification examinations. I mean, and now we are a world metropolis, and the quality of our universities have been well supported by ASEAN countries. We can be a source of talents for ASEAN countries that can be considered in our overall policy. Mr. Tang Fei, thank you for allowing me to speak for the second time. In our list of outstanding items, we have this item on a review of the governance of UGC-funded institutions. I think the members will have no objection to that because many universities, including my alma mater, had controversies about the selection of new vice chancellor. There were also calls to review the governance and structure of UGC-funded institutions, and also the vetting mechanism for funding under research grant commission should also be reviewed. After the Black Cloud violence, there was a subject that aroused a wide concern, and that is there was a fellowship, a Fulbright Hong Kong program run by American institutes. Now, it was suspended for a while, but now it has resumed. Of course, we welcome exchange in the academic sector, but if that is used as a pretext for activities that threaten national security, I think it should be a concern to the RGC. Thank you. Thank you. Members have given us many good suggestions. I'd like to add a few items to the list. First, on decline of student population in September 2021. As far back as that, we already asked for a discussion in the Education Bureau panel. Hopefully, the administration can give us a briefing on this topic. It's been more than 1.5 years since we first raised that topic. Second, citizenship and social development subject, teacher qualifications, and how teachers are doing. after we have abolished liberal studies, we'd like to know whether the curriculum as well as the examination papers are really living up to our expectation. After we have replaced the liberal studies subjects with this, as regards national education, we all went on a visit to the resource center, and we found out that their resources were limited, even though the center was playing an important role. So we can follow up on that. And then apart from local schools, our international schools should have a basic understanding of the Constitution, basic law, national security law, the national flag and national emblem. Because of incidents involving the wrong playing of our national anthem, we now realized that this is an important issue, and we should take care of all education institutions in Hong Kong. When it comes to governance of UGC-funded institutions, we will continue to follow up. Some members are thinking of a private members' bill to amend the relevant legislation. We may have a few private members' bill on the governance of universities, hoping to improve their governance structure. The concern over RGC, I agree with the proposal. We have to understand the operation of the UGC to find out the reason for some of the problems we have seen. Members have raised excellent suggestions. Of course, we must not leave out special education. We have been following that since last year, and also the retention of graduates. We may consider using fiscal incentives or other kinds of incentives to retain talents in Hong Kong. We really have a problem of brain drain, and I ask the Education Bureau to discuss with us decline in population, student population, as soon as possible. And then vocational and professional education is also an issue. The kind of life planning students should be exposed to, and when they can be allowed to make the choice. So we will have a meeting with the Education Bureau together with the Deputy Chairman. We will work out our plan as soon as possible. So members' views are well noted. Mental health. Well, indeed, 3 years after the epidemic and when life has resumed normalcy, this is also an issue. So thank you very much, members. Do you have other suggestions? If not, AOB. Do we have any AOB items? If not, then the meeting is adjourned. Thank you very much.